Good morning, students. Welcome once again back to the online classes presented to you by Sri Vidya Mandir Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Puthangarai, Krishnagiri District. I hope you students are all safe and well at your home and keenly following the lessons provided to you through these online classes. I advise you to follow these lessons keenly and enrich yourself. Students, today this video is going to deal with the grammatical section, question number 23 for the 10th standard. In section 3, question number 23, the change of voice. The change of voice, that is the transformation of sentence from active to passive. Now, let us go to the lesson. Students, today's topic deals with the active and passive voice. What is an active voice and what is a passive voice? When in a sentence the subject does the action, the action is important, then the sentence is said to be in the active voice. For example, if we take a sentence, Rama killed Ravana, here the action is killed and it is done by the subject Rama. Hence, it is said to be in the active voice. Similarly, when the subject receives or suffers the action, it is said to be in the passive voice. For example, let us take the same sentence, Ravana was killed by Ram. Here Ravana is the subject and was killed is the verb. Here Ravana suffers, receives the action. The subject receives the action and hence it is said to be in the passive voice. When do we use this active voice? When do we prefer to say in active voice? And when do we prefer to say in the passive voice? We prefer to say in the active voice when importance is given to the action done by the subject. In those sentences, we prefer to use the active voice. Similarly, when importance is given to what happens to the subject, what is the action or what the subject undergoes is to be given importance, then we use the passive voice. A sentence can be transformed from active to passive only when the verb is transitive. So, when a sentence is given, we have to see and find the verb, subject and object first, and then we should enter into the transformation so that it could be easy. Let me work out an example. Now, the cat killed the rat. Here, the verb is killed, the action is killed. The subject, the action is done by the cat. Hence, this is said to be in the active voice. More importance is given to what the subject does, and hence it is in the active voice. Whereas, the rat was killed by the cat. In this sentence, again, we find out the verb was killed. The subject is the rat. Here, the rat, it does not do the action, but it receives the action, it suffers the action. Hence, this is said to be in the passive voice. When, what happens to the subject or what the subject undergoes is highlighted, the sentence is said to be in the passive voice. And when the importance is given to the subject, the action, what the subject does, then it is said to be in the active voice. We prefer to use the active voice. When do we prefer to use the passive voice? We prefer to use the passive voice particularly when it is not necessary to mention the performer. The thief was arrested. I know that the police is going to arrest him, but I need not mention the police there. So, when it is not necessary to mention the performer, we can prefer the passive form. Further, when we don't remember or we have forgotten, when we don't know who the performer is, we can prefer the passive voice. Similarly, when people are used in general as performers, then we can prefer the passive voice. For example, these American newspapers can be read in the library, in this library. So, this is generally done by people in common, and hence it is not necessary to write by people. This is preferred to be written in the passive form. We can use the passive voice. We can use the passive form where we want to avoid some awkward structures. For example, when John came late to school, the teacher scolded him. This can be better expressed as, in the passive form, when John came late to the class, he was scolded. We can avoid the teacher. Further, we can prefer passive forms for psychological reasons where we want to avoid telling the name. We may know the person who has done it, but we want to avoid giving out the name. For example, these files have been opened. I know the person who has opened my files, but I don't want to tell his name. In such cases, we can prefer the passive forms. And finally, when we are interested in the action itself, we can prefer the passive form. A new stadium is being built in our campus. You are more interested in the action, and so it is said to be in the passive form. Similarly, my friend's properties have been auctioned. We have been more attracted towards the action, and hence it can be said in the passive form. These are the ways where we can prefer to use the passive voice. Now, coming over to the passive voice, there are two types of proxy voice. There are two types of passive voices. One is the personal passive, whereas the other one is the impersonal passive. In the personal passive, the doer of the action is mentioned or known. It is mentioned in the sentence, given sentence. For example, I can say, eggs are laid by the hen. Hamlet was written by Shakespeare. So, when it is the person who has done the action is known, it is personal. He has been arrested. My book was stolen. Here, I don't know. The person or doer of the action is not mentioned, and hence it is called the impersonal passive. Now coming over to the passive structure. Passive structure. In most of the passive forms, the performer is unimportant, it is not mentioned. You should remember that. In passive structure, what is the structure of the passive voice? The passive voice structure, there will be a be verb or any helping verb plus V3 or the past participle, third form of the verb or the past participle. This structure you should try to understand. It can be like this or it can be like with any be or helping verb plus a non-finite verb like be, being or been in between, again followed by a V3. This can be in this structure. This structure is said to be the passive one. One should be a helping verb, the other one should be a past participle with any non-finite verb like be, being or been in between. You can easily identify a given sentence and tell whether it is passive or active by just looking at its structure. Deriving the passive voice. For deriving the passive voice, how do we derive at the passive voice? First, we should know that a sentence should be having a transitive verb for it to be transformed into either active or passive. We should find out the verb, the subject and the object. Then we have to interchange the subject and the object. We have to interchange the subject and the object. Next, we should check the tense used in the question. We should check the number, that is whether the changed subject is singular or plural or not. We should transform the, we should interchange the subject with the object. We should check whether what is the tense given in the question. When the object becomes the subject, we should check whether it is in the singular or plural. Then we should add V3 to it. Before the V3, you put the suitable auxiliary form, auxiliary verb, mostly a be verb, whatever it is, the suitable auxiliary verb. You put by after the V3. You put by after the V3 and then you add the suitable changed object. It can be a pronoun also. This is the way you derive a passive form from an active sentence. Let us look at an example. He wrote a letter. Now, first, for deriving the passive, I check whether what voice this given sentence, the subject, verb and object is found out. The subject does the action and hence it is in the active voice. Now, I have to transform it into the passive voice. Now, for deriving the passive, what I should do? I should interchange the subject with the object and object with the subject. So, the object here is a letter. A letter comes first. Now, I check the tense in the given question. The tense in the given question is past tense. So, for past tense, I should know also check the number. I should check the number whether the changed object into subject, the changed subject is singular or plural. It is past tense. Now, it is singular. So, I have to use a suitable helping verb, an auxiliary verb. For past tense singular, I use the auxiliary verb was. I add the V3 to it. The V3 of wrote is written. The V3 of wrote is written. Then I bring the subject to the object after using the word by. A letter was written by this him will take the objective form him. So, now the letter suffers the action and this is said to be in the passive voice. For this, we should know the transformation of the change of pronouns. There are only certain pronouns that get changed. Let us have a look at them. The change of pronouns. Only these pronouns get changed, others remain the same. For example, in the active voice, this is the passive voice. If I use I in the active voice, it gets changed into me. He will become him. She will become her. We will become us. They will become them. You will be you. It will be it. These are the change in pronouns that is used in the active and passive voice. Now you see, here he was used in the active and it becomes him. If I had been used, it will become me. If she had been used, it will become her. We will become us, they will become them. You will become you and it will be remain as it. This is the change in the pronoun as far as active and passive is concerned. Now, coming to the change in the auxiliary verb, in selecting the auxiliary verb, let us have a look at the table. The singular, plural, for present tense, in the active voice, the present tense singular is represented by is or am. The verb will be in the S form or VES form also. Go, goes, for example. In present tense, it is like this, is or am. In the plural form I use for present tense, the auxiliary verb used is are. For past tense, I use singular was or verb in the ed form. Here I use where. In present tense, we can also add the be verbs, do verbs. Does is used for singular, do is used for plural, has is used for singular, have is used for plural. In past tense, we use was and were. The verb will also be in the ed form of past tense. or whatever vocabulary form it might take in the past form. In the future, it will be will, shall, or any modal auxiliary. Any modal auxiliary. For this, we use for singular as well as plural. We add the word be, and then it is followed by V3. Then it is followed by V3 in the passive form. Here for the passive form, we use is, am for singular plus V3 of the given verb. If it is in the plural, we use are plus V3. For example, here we have written, he wrote a letter. For past tense, we use was for singular. So, a letter was past tense. A letter is singular. The tense used in the sentence is past tense. So, for past tense singular, the verb that we take is was. And the V3 of wrote is written. Then we add, after the V3, we add the word by and use the, we bring the subject to object and he becomes him. This we have seen already in the change of pronouns. So, we have used was plus V3. This is one, for singular it will be was plus V3. If it was in the plural, the passive form will be were plus V3. Suppose, the given sentence comes out like this, he wrote two letters. I cannot write two letters was written. I cannot write two letters was written. The subject and verb should agree. So, I should write two letters were written. That is why singular, plural, I have told you, I have given you a hint. If it is in the future, it will be in the, you will, shall, or any model will be there. For this, for both singular and plural, for the passive form, we come with will. If it is will, we say will plus be plus V3. If the sentence is given like, he will write a letter, or he will write two letters, whatever it is, the answer will be in the passive form. If it is a letter will be written by him. If it is two letters also, two letters will be written by him. This is the three tense forms are used involving the passive. Overall, the passive will take 8 tense forms, out of which we have seen 3. And let us look at the remaining 5 of them. Now let us go to the continuous form, progressive tense. In present continuous tense, in the active form, in the question, it will be in the active form, it will be is or am plus verb in the ing form. In the plural, it will be are plus verb in the ing form. Let us take the example here with that same thing. He is writing a letter. This is, suppose if it is in the plural, they are playing cricket. Here the subject is plural, so the verb is plural. Here the verb is singular, subject is singular, so the verb is also singular. So in present continuous, is the form is either is plus verb in the ing form or am. If it is I am writing a letter. So present continuous is or am plus verb plus ing or plus verb plus ing in the plural form. Now let us take this example. He is writing a letter. In the passive form, for continuous we should add being. So the passive form will be he is writing a letter. In the singular form it will be is being. The word being will be added for continuous, then it will be followed by the V3. A letter is singular, so I use is. A letter is being written by him. If it is two letters, then you use the plural form are for present tense. Two letters are being written by him. This is for the continuous. If for the past continuous, for the past continuous, the structure will be was plus verb in the ing form. He was writing a letter. If it is in the plural form, they were writing a letter. For this, the passive form will be, passive voice will be was plus being plus suitable V3. If it is in the plural form, it will be were plus being plus V3. In the given sentence, for example, he was writing a letter, we change the subject and the object, a letter, singular, I use was for past tense, continuous tense, and hence I add the word being, then I add by him. If it was in the plural, he was writing two letters were being written by him, were being written by him. If it is in the plural, were being written, singular, was being written. Similarly, there is no form for the future continuous, passive form for future continuous. We have the perfect tense. In the present perfect, the present perfect will carry the structure. For singular, it will be has plus V3. For plural, it will be have plus V3. He has written a letter. This is the present perfect form. He has written a letter. If it is in the plural, they have written a letter. For this, the passive will be, you have to add the word been. For singular, it will be has plus been plus V3. If it is plural, it should be have plus been plus V3. He has written a letter has been written by him. In the continuous form, we use the word being for continuous. For perfect, we use the word non-finite verb been in between. A letter has been written by him. You should know that I and you take the plural form and hence will always have this plural form. They will take the plural verb. I is an exception which will take am in the present tense. Then we have future perfect. The future perfect where, past perfect. The past perfect, it is nothing but had plus v3, both in singular as well as plural, it will be the same. So in the passive form, for past perfect, it will be had plus been plus v3. They had written a letter. He had written a letter. For this, he had written a letter is past perfect. The answer will be a letter had been written by him. If it is in the plural, those letters had been. There is singular and plural, both will not differ in the past perfect form. And finally, for the future perfect, the structure will be will plus have plus v3 in the active form. This will plus have plus v3 will take will plus have plus been plus v3 in the passive form for future perfect. For example, if I am writing this sentence, he will have written the letter, the passive form for this, the passive form for will have written will have been written. Both for singular and plural, it remains the same. So, the change, after the change of subject and object, a letter, the verb will have been written by him. Whether it is singular, he will have written the letters, then also it is going to remain the same. But the subject here, I have to change, the letters will have been written by him. These are the change form that occurs as far as the change in the auxiliary verbs, the verb structure is taking place in the active passive form. I would like to revise this again. I would say, when a sentence is given, I find out the verb action first, the subject and the object. I find out whether the given sentence is in the active voice or in the passive voice. Then accordingly, if it is in the active voice, I interchange the subject and object. I check the tense given in the question, then I go to the interchanged subject, I check the singular plural for it, I check the number whether it is singular or plural, then I add a suitable auxiliary according to its merit, then I add it with the third form of the verb. Then after that I add the preposition by, after which I again bring the subject into the changed object as brought here. Really, whether it, accordingly, if it is the pronoun, that pronoun should be used correctly. We have seen the list of pronouns, change of pronouns, and you can use to learn from it and write it. We should remember, if the given sentence is having the verb in the future using will, shall, or any model, or any modal auxiliary in it, has any modal auxiliary in it, we should remember to add, suppose if it is will, we should remember to add will plus be plus v3. We should remember to add the word be. He will write a story. Now what will happen? A story will come first. It is singular, hence it is in the future, so there is no question of singular plural for this. A story will change into will plus be plus v3, will be written. This structure will be written. A story will be written by him. We should remember, for continuous tense, for continuous progressive tense, when verb is in the ing form, we should remember to add the word being in between. Before the V3 we add being, then we use the suitable auxiliary or the helping verb according to the singular and plural status. If it is in the perfect tense, again we should remember to add the word been before the V3, and again we have the suitable auxiliary before it. These are the things which you should remember for transforming a sentence from active to passive or vice versa. Now I will tell you a shortcut method of approaching this. Any sentence, if it is given, you just find out the verb first, then you find out the subject, then you identify the object. Now you interchange the object with the subject and the subject with the object. That is what we saw, that you should add a suitable auxiliary and then the V3 should be added for transforming it into passive. We should remember, we should check whether the given sentence is in the active voice or in the passive voice. Remember, if the sentence is in the active voice, when it is changed into passive, the number of verbs in it will decrease. If the number of words used in the active voice is 2, it will, in passive voice it will be 3, it will increase. Suppose if you are changing from active voice to passive voice, if the number of words, verbs used in the auxiliary, in the active voice is 2, in passive voice it will decrease to 1. So based on this, in a given sentence when you find the verb, you can easily construct the structure of the verb and then interchange the subject and object accordingly. That will make you to approach this active passive form very, very easily. It will make it easy for you. Now let me go through some example sentences from your textbook. In your textbook there is a sentence, the manager appointed, many office assistants, This is the given sentence. Now I told you how to approach this. Let me find out the verb first. In this, the verb is appointed. The subject is manager. The manager subject does the action, hence it is in the active voice. I have to change it into passive form. When I change from active to passive, the verb increases. If it is 1 here, in passive it will be 2. Appointed is there. Now this appointed should change into 2 verbs. I will interchange the subject with the object. Appointed, I check the tense of appointed, it is in the past tense. The interchanged object becomes the subject. Many assistants. Many assistants is plural. This is in plural form. So many assistants, the tense used here is appointed, which is past tense. According to the table, for past tense plural, the verb, auxiliary verb that we take, B form of the verb that we take is were. Then we add the V3 of appointed. The third form of appointed is appointed. So appointed becomes were appointed here. Suppose if it was assistant and not, it is an office assistant. If the sentence was in singular, if this assistant was made to be singular, now when it is interchanged, this will become an assistant, and hence for past tense singular, the verb would have been was, and the V3 would have been the same. But here, in the given sentence, as the object here is in plural form, when it is interchanged as the subject, it is in the plural form, it takes the helping verb, be verb, auxiliary verb is were, then the V3 past participle of appointed is appointed, and I bring the subject to the object by, after using the preposition by the manager. You see, one verb has become two here. So, this is in the active form, the subject does the action. Here, the subject suffers the action, receives the action, and hence it is said to be in the passive form. So, this is how I approach that. I make it very simple. I find the verb, I interchange the subject object accordingly, and then I use the suitable auxiliary verb and add the V3. Suppose if this given sentence was in the continuous form, I would have added in between, I would have added being. If it was in the perfect form, I would have added been in between. If it is in the future or any model had been used, I would have added be in between. This is the logic that you should apply for converting the active to passive form, whatever form, whether it is the other way also. Now, let us change from passive to active. Many assistants were appointed by the manager. Who appointed a manager? Now, the manager will come first. So, I will write the manager were appointed, it is two, it will become one in active. So, I will remove this, I will say appointed. Appointed is there because it is the past tense used. Appointed, where is in the past tense. Appointed, who appointed whom? The manager appointed many office assistants. Now, the action is done by the subject and becomes into the active voice. So, using this technique or strategy, you can easily convert the sentences, given sentence, from active to passive. Let us look at one more example from your sentence, from your textbook. You are making a cake now. You are making a cake now. Again, I go just find out the verb, then I find out the subject, I find out the object. Making what? A cake. Who is making? You. You is the subject. Now, I will interchange the subject and the object, object with subject. A cake will be used first. It is singular. The tense used here is ing form, the verb making. The verb is in the ing form, it is progressive continuous form. So, I should remember to add being. You making, it is in the active form. So, in the passive form, a cake. Cake is singular. For singular, I use the auxiliary verb is. For continuous, I use the word being is added. A cake is being. The V3 of make is made. The cake is being made by you now. So, you are making. You, hence it takes the plural form am, are here. But here, the subject is cake, it takes the singular form, is. For being continuous, being is added, then the V3 is added. A cake is being made by you now. This is the passive form. Similarly, you go through the exercises that has been given in the textbook, and you will find it very easy to transform the given sentence, whether it is in the passive or in the active. Let me work out one more example from the textbook. the militants were being taken. The militants were being taken to prison by the police. The militants were being taken to prison by the police. Here, the subject is the militants. Were being taken is the verb. To prison. Were being taken to prison by whom? By the police. So, the action is being taken. The subject is militants. They are not doing the action. They are suffering the action. So, this given sentence is in the passive form. I have to change it into the active voice. When I have to change the active voice, the doer of the action will come first. So, the police, the verb here, were being taken, being is used, that means the verb is in the ing form. The tense used here is past tense. The police is always used in the plural form, and so I used the plural form for past tense is were. The auxiliary word were being, so the verb should be in the ing form. Take will become taking. So, were being taken will change into were taking. If the subject was singular, it would be was taking. The police were taking whom? The militants. The police were taking the militants to prison. This is the answer for this. Again, the crude method. In the passive form, the subject is suffering, so it is in the passive. There are three verbs. When it is in the passive to active, the verb gets reduced. Here two, here it is three, it will be two here. So, it is two here, were taking. Thus, we can see these types of sentences can be transformed into active and passive. One more final thing I will transfer. Rosie, his behavior vexes me. His behavior vexes me. His behavior is the subject, vexes is the verb, me is the object. Now, I interchange. Me will become I. This is me will become I. Tense. This is the present tense, and in present tense I will take am as the auxiliary. Vex. V3 of vex is vexed. I am vexed by his behavior. I am vexed by his behavior. This is active, this is passive. Subject vexes me. I am vexed by his behavior. Now, there are other types of sentences in active passive. Let us look at some of the other types. We have, for example, a sentence with two objects. Say, from your textbook I have taken this sentence. Pragati will lend a pen to Geeta. Pragati will lend a pen to Geeta. Now, the verb here is will lend. The subject is Pragati. There is an object here. I can also write the same as he gave me a pen. Here the verb is here, he is the subject, this is an object, this is an object. Me is the indirect object and pen is the direct object. This is the usual pattern for this given sentence. This sentence pattern will normally come like this in the indirect and direct object in this order. But certain times the sentence will come like that, will end. This is the direct object here and the indirect object here. When in structures where the direct objects come first, the indirect object should be preceded by the preposition to or for. Here the preposition to is used. Normally the structure will be like this, but at times the structure will come like this also. Now, for converting this from, transforming this from, this is the active voice, he gave, the action is done. For converting this into passive, I can use either of these two in this first sentence. I can either use me or I can use a pen. If I use me, me will become I. If I use pen, a pen will be the subject. The verb here is gave. Gave will not differ. I is singular, so it is was, plus V3 of give is given. A pen is also singular, it will also take was, the V3 is given. The structure of this verb did not change. I was given a pen by him. If I use a pen was given, I should use before the indirect form the preposition to me. A pen was given to me by him. I can use either of these objects. So, when there are two objects, I should take care and see which object can be perfectly used. Here in this sentence, I can say a pen. This is in the future tense, hence I will say a pen will, future you should be careful to remember, B should be added, the V3 of lend is lent, a pen will be lent to Geeta by Pragati. Geeta will be lent a pen by Pragati. I can use either of these two methods. This is one type of transformation where we use when we find two objects in the given sentence. We might also come across imperative sentences. An imperative sentence, each command, a command will be used. There will be an order, advice, request, instruction, something. For such sentences, for example, if I say, open the door, open the door. Don't open the door, don't open the window. Imperative sentence. I can use two methods here. One, I can use the word let. I can say let for this one. Let the door be opened. Let the door open will become be opened. Let the door be opened. For the sentence 2, don't is used there. I can use let not the door be opened. Let not the door be opened. Or I can say let the door not be opened. I can use either of it. Let the door not be opened. I can use the word let and bring the passive form. At the same time, since this is an order imperative sentence, I can also use one more method. I can say, you are asked to open the door. You are asked to open the door. Instead of, I can use let the door be opened, at the same time I can also say that you are asked to open the door. This is also correct. For example, if it is an imperative sentence, please give me a pen. I can say let me be given a pen, please. This is one type. I can also say, since it is a request, I can use you are requested to give me a pen. You are requested to give me a pen. So in an imperative sentence, if it is a request, if the word please is used, I can say you are requested to, you are, please call me at once. If this is the given sentence, you are requested to call me at once. I can write the passive form in this way. Similarly, if it is an order, I can say order, get out. You are ordered to get out. You are ordered to get out. You are ordered to get out. This is the passive form. If it is in an instruction, I can say you are instructed to write your names on the paper, something like that. So for imperatives, I can say like this. I can also at times use the word let. For the sentence, may God bless you, I can say may you be blessed by God. May you be blessed by God. I use may. May you be blessed by God. Certain words, certain will start with let itself. Let her bring chocolates. Let her bring chocolates. For this, let her bring chocolates. Let chocolates be brought by her. Let chocolates be brought by her. I can use it in this form for the passive. Let chocolates be brought by her. Let her bring chocolates. This is the active and passive forms. In certain sentence, in another type, my watch has been stolen. My watch has been stolen. Here, the subject is my watch, has been stolen is the verb. The object, it is, I don't know who has stolen the watch. So I have to insert the object. I don't know who it is, I say someone. Has been stolen is in, been is there perfect tense. It is passive form, receiving the action. So, three will become two verbs. Has been stolen will become has stolen. Someone has stolen my watch. Someone has stolen my watch. Here, this is the active form. When we write the passive form, when there are words like someone, no one, somebody, none, I need not mention this. This can be omitted at the end. This can be omitted at the end. Even people, by people need not be said. When people are performers in general, I can omit that. That should be remembered. Suppose, if the sentence given is like, nobody has bought the tickets. Nobody has bought the tickets. Has bought is the verb here. Has bought, this is the active voice. It will change into passive. Has bought will change into has been bought. But the object that is being transferred here is the tickets. The tickets, it is plural, so has will not come. I will use have. The tickets have been bought, but it says nobody has bought, so I should take care to add the word not. The tickets have not been bought. The tickets have not been bought by nobody, by somebody, anybody. I should not write that, it can be omitted. The tickets have not been bought. I should remember to add the word not when there is nobody, no one, none in the negative. When it is like that, I have to add the word not to transform it into the passive form. Now, coming to questions. When it comes to questions, there are two types of questions. One is yes or no type questions. One is WH questions. Let me run through some examples taken from your textbook. Now, for yes or no type questions, did he eat the mangoes? Did he eat the mangoes? This is a yes or no type question. Now, did he eat the mangoes? Did he eat? It is in the active form. When I change it into the passive form, this interrogative question, it will begin in a auxiliary. Did is given in the past tense. Did is given in the past tense. The mangoes is here. He is here. He should go back. Mangoes will come to the front. Mangoes is plural. The tense used is past tense. So, for past tense plural, I will write where the mangoes. Mangoes will come to the front. Where the mangoes? The V3 of eat is eaten. Where the mangoes? Eaten by him. Where the mangoes? Eaten by him. Are you playing cricket? Are you playing cricket? Again, this is a yes or no type question. When I change it into from the active voice to passive voice, the auxiliary verb will come. Cricket, you will take or, but cricket is singular. Cricket will come first, you will go next. Cricket is singular, present tense it will take, or is present tense, is the singular, is cricket. This is in the ing form, so I will add being, is cricket being, V3 of play is played by you, is cricket being played by you. This is the way I deal with this question, yes or no type. When it comes to the WH type, in the WH type, let me see an example. When will you accept this offer? When will you accept this offer? This is in the active voice. I have to change it into passive. There is a WH word. We should remember when we use the WH word, we should have a question word first. After the question word, then we will have the verb. After that, it will be a subject because it is a question. The verb will first come first in a question before the subject. You should take care. When, this is the question word, when will this offer? Offer will come first, you will go. When will this offer? Will, verb will be there. When will this offer? Will accept will change, will be accepted. When will this offer be accepted? So, will accept will change into will बी एक्सेप्टेड, फ्यूचर विल चेक बी इन बिटवीन, व्हेन विल दिस ऑफर बी एक्सेप्टेड बाय यू. इफ इट इज अ क्वेश्चन हु इन्वेंटेड टेलीविजन, आई कैन राइट बाय हूम वॉज टेलीविजन इन्वेंटेड, by whom was television invented, don't forget to put the question mark, by whom. I can also write who was television invented by, I can also write like this, who was television invented by. So when it comes to questions, this is a, when it is who, I can use by whom, the question word followed by the verb. When it is yes or no type, it will start with a auxiliary verb. This is what I should remember regarding the transformation involving questions. Now, I want to enlighten you with certain odd, strange things. Finally, normally we use by in the passive, but there are some exceptions which you have to be careful. We use other prepositions instead of by. Let us look at that set of words where we don't use by. Look at this set of words: surprised, annoyed, disappointed, laughed, shocked, etc. We don't use the word by for this. We use at. For example, your success surprises me. Your success surprises me. If I say your success surprises me, the word surprises is used. This is in the active form. Passive form, I am surprised. I am surprised. I will take am surprised. Me will become I am surprised. I am surprised. I don't use by. I use I am surprised at your. I am surprised at your success. I am surprised at your success. I use I. So the words, these words you should be careful when you use. You don't use by, you use at. Surprised, annoyed, disappointed, laughed, shocked, alarmed, etc. Similarly, again you should know the set of known, married, obliged. Known, if the given sentence is I know him, I know him, I should not, he will become, him will become he is singular, he is, no, the V3 of no is known, he is known, by me should not be written, I should write to me, I should write to. Known, obliged and married will carry to instead of by. Similarly, pleased, satisfied, decorated, filled, impressed, disgusted, etc. will carry the preposition with. They will carry the preposition with instead of by. This room is filled with sweet fragrance. Filled with. Sweet fragrance fills this room. I should use the word with, not by. The stage has been decorated with colorful festoons. Has been decorated with. They have decorated the stage with colorful festoons. Decorated should carry with. Similarly, the set of words involved, included, contained, interested, absorbed will carry the preposition in. They will not carry by. For example, in a sentence, these terms are not included in the agreement. These terms are not included in the agreement. The agreement does not include these terms. The agreement does not include the, this is the active form. If you use in the passive, I should not say the agreement does not include these terms. The passive form, these terms are not included by the agreement should not be said. We should included in the agreement should be said. So these are some odd ones where the usage of preposition you should be careful. So run through the exercises that is given in your textbook, go through them, apply the method that I have taught you, you will easily follow and you will be able to transform these sentences in either way, whether it is active to passive or passive to active. I hope you would have understood the lesson. Exercise, follow, complete the exercises and try to understand by yourself and consult your teachers in case if there is any doubt. Thank you.